Hi, I'm Dr.A.Santhosh Kumar, practicing as consultant urologist, andrologist and renal transplant surgeon at Lux Hospital, Gachibowli, Hyderabad. Kidney stones are the stones which can form in the kidney, ureter, bladder or urethra. So these stones usually form primarily in the kidney, but they can displace to the lower urinary tract. So patients may have various conditions, like either he can present with pain abdomen, either right side or left side, depends on the location of the stone. Or patient may have associated fever, vomitings. Some patient may have blood in the urine. So depends on the location of the size, the severity of the symptoms the patient is presenting. These patients may need either surgery or they can be treated medically based on the diagnosis. If it is a simple stone, if patient is not having acute symptoms and where the stone size is very small, less than 5 mm, these patients can be treated medically. But if the stone is irrespective of the size, stone is causing symptoms, acute renal failure, or patient is presenting acutely with high-grade fever, these patients may need procedures. So whenever a patient presents with stone either into the OPD or emergency department, we do few investigations. It can be basic ultrasonography of the kidney, ureter and bladder. It can be associated with urine routine examination. And if you are suspecting if patient has additional factors, then we'll be doing routine blood examination like CBP and RFT. These are the few criteria where we can get to a conclusion or where we can get to the diagnosis that patient is having stone. When a patient is having obstructive symptoms, not responding to medication, then we go for advanced investigations like CT scan of kidney, ureter and bladder. So this will be the 100% where we can definitely tell that this patient is having stone and this patient may or may not respond to medical treatment and this patient most probably needs surgery. The most common cause of renal swelling in children is nothing but PUJ obstruction, what we call as PUJ obstruction. That is Pelviuretric Junction obstruction, where the ureter transfers into the pelvis of the kidney. Usually most of these children are diagnosed nowadays in the antenatal scans only. And whenever the baby is diagnosed to have antenatal PUJO, post-delivery the child will be followed. And depends on the aggressive nature, either it can be unilateral or bilateral. And if it is affecting the kidney, definitely he need to undergo pyeloplasty, which is a procedure which can be done minimal invasive or open surgery. So this PUJ obstruction can affect the kidney negatively, where the kidney function will come down. And if it is bilateral, there are chances it can be landed in acute kidney failure also. So these patients will need a definitive procedure called pyeloplasty, where we remove the abnormal ureter and connect it to the normal ureter.